That wakes me up right around 6 a.m. and he was early this morning, 4 o'clock. He must have been excited. It's the same thing that Sylvie said. It's the same thing that Sylvie said when I was trying to put her to bed last night. She said she couldn't close her eyes and go to sleep because she was so excited. One of the things that my kids always look forward to our peeps. And Abby said that that was a big part of her childhood as well, although she didn't like them. And I have never had one in my whole life. And I will try one with you now. When in Rome, Easter, trying a peep. But of course, Easter isn't just about peeps, is it? Let's consider what that first Easter was like. There were no joyful celebrations or churches packed with parishioners. Instead, there was fear and anxiety and crushing disappointment for them and us all now not being able to be together this morning. Across the generations, we all know what the grave feels like. But this morning, This morning is Easter, and this is the fullness of the story. For God always promises to raise the dead. They saw their hope fleeting. They had seen Jesus laid in the tomb. And now, when the women came, they were ready to prepare a body for death, for burial. We know those first Christians couldn't understand what really had happened. After all we have been through, now more than ever, we get it. We understand it, how the world had changed utterly and completely.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
bit tired of the stream of bad news. Some of us are tired from the effort of trying not to freak out. Some of us are a bit weary of not knowing how we'll pay rent. Some of us are a bit exhausted from the effort of trying to entertain and educate and feed and love children who are stuck at home. Some of us are exhausted by the 13-hour shifts, and we no longer recognize the work in front of us. Working a job we are afraid might endanger us and our loved ones. Some of us showed up to this pandemic with pre-existing physical and mental health conditions that were already tough. Some of us are tired by loneliness and yearn for church. Some of us are exhausted by waiting so long for a new season of Succession on HBO. And some of us are exhausted by the effort of trying to make this all okay for everyone else. Even on Easter, life is a bit strained and tender right now. So give us your resurrection power and spirit. Give us today our daily resurrected strength, for it is Easter. Strength for today, bright hope for tomorrow. Amen.
Jesus is risen. After the Sabbath, as the first day of the week was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to see the tomb. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord, descending from heaven, came and rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothing white as snow. For fear of him, the guards shook and became like dead men. But the angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid. I know that you are looking for Jesus who was crucified. He is not here, for he has been raised as he said. Come, see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples. He has been raised from the dead, and indeed he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him. This is my message for you." So they left the tomb quickly with fear and great joy and ran to his disciples. Suddenly, Jesus met them and said, "Greetings." And they came to him, took hold of his feet, and worshipped him. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee. There they will see me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Kids! That's one of my favorite things to do. And when I say that, our children, they come running up to the front, and our chancel would be packed right now with them. In this moment, I speak to them, and I speak to them about one of my favorite books. And it is, that may be hard to see a bit, but it's called The Monster at the End of This Book, starring our very good friend, Grover. And somebody told Grover that the end of the book, there will be a monster. And so he does not want to turn the pages, and page after page, he says, "Oh, you turned the page." And we get closer and closer to the end. He tries to string up the pages. He tries to build a wall, and we just keep trucking along, don't we? "This will stop you from turning the pages," he says. "Do you know that you are very strong?" All of our kids. I tell my kids at home and all of our kids here at church, "You are strong, you are tough, and you are brave." And Grover says, "Please, please, please, don't turn the page." But sure enough, there we go, to the very, very end. And Grover says, Well, look at that. This is the end of the book. And the only one here is us, together. I'm lovable. I'm furry Grover. And the monster at the end of this book is me. And we were all a bit scared. I told you and told you there was nothing to be afraid of, Grover says, at the end. Sylvie mentioned to me earlier on this week that the story of Jesus concentrates on his birth. And then we discussed his later life and the stories that occurred, the miracles, his teachings, and then, of course, the struggle, and then the great and grand miracle of God bringing him back to life. And in the midst of it, we were honest that there were scary parts, especially for those there who went then to the tomb. And they were headed to the tomb to pay their respects and prepare the body. And after all that they experienced, like Grover, they were afraid. And each step they took to the tomb was perhaps even more and more difficult. And not only fear, but there was sadness. There was perhaps even this urge for them to turn back, like initially Grover in the book. But when the women get to the tomb, there is great joy. We're in that moment right now. We have a ton of emotions and feelings right now. And we have an urge to run in the midst of the uncertainty. But the time will come and we will gather just like the women at the tomb. And there was great joy. Can you just imagine? Sure, it's Easter and we are celebrating it with all of our gusto, but we can't without being shoulder to shoulder with one another. So when we get back together, it will be Easter anew and there will be great joy. And surprise beyond all surprises, for Jesus is alive.
Thank you.
take for granted moving forward. And for certain, one of those aspects of life is church and being with all of you. Our mission is strong. As ever before, it is about spiritual care and walking with one another. Walking not just with one another, but with the resurrected Christ. We now receive and gather our offering for our bright future together. I invite you to go to our website, holycrossduluth.org/give, to give of your heart in this time, for it is God's work, our hands. We're living in a time now when Easter celebrations will not be as they have always been. This morning I pulled out the ham and it was rock hard solid. And I thought about all the family gatherings that we have ever had and my kids being with their grandparents. And this time will be different, although not less special. Eventually that ham will be thawed and my kids and Abby, we will have our meal together. We long for each other, not just for our church, but our extended family. I long for all of you as we're physically distanced from one another. There is one act, and one act only. It's actually a meal, and you know this meal. This meal brings us together across all time and space. It gives us all that we need, love, life, and forgiveness this very moment. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should all time and all places give thanks and praise to you, almighty and merciful God, for the glorious resurrection of our Savior Jesus Christ, the true Paschal Lamb who gave himself to take away our sin, who in dying has destroyed death, and in rising has brought us to eternal life. And so with Mary Magdalene and Peter and all the witnesses of the resurrection, with earth and sea and all their creatures, and with angels and archangels and cherubim and seraphim, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Himself over, took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, given for you for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." And again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." Gathered into one by the strong and promised Holy Spirit, let us pray the prayer that our Lord Jesus has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not in temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. especially for those who find yourself alone in this moment, I am with you, and hear the external words of grace from our God of the resurrection in Jesus Christ. The body of Christ broken for you, and the blood of Christ shed for you. I'm so very proud of our church and our church collect across this country and around the globe who are doing God's work. We are Christian and we are proud of it. Sharing this meal and in song, we move forward, onward together. For Christ is alive, and we sing, let Christians sing. In some of the regions of the country, the CDC has determined that the peak of the virus will happen and is happening right now. And this fact isn't lost on us. The forces of death are raising their strength at the very moment when Jesus was raised from the dead. I think on this Easter, we can sing our alleluias. Nevertheless, we might be a little tentative at first, the way the women were when they came to the tomb. Like the disciples who were locked in the upper room. Under it all, there is a hope growing and a renewed strength, alleluia, as we realize that life is continuing and that God holds the future. Yes, there will be defiance that our God will use as we take a look at death and all those deadly forces and say, You will not win. And finally, there will be joy. The everlasting joy that God loves us completely and has brought us into eternal life. Christ is risen. Alleluia. songs that Abby and the girls and I are singing quite a bit is the old hymn, God be with you till we meet again. Certainly, that's the case. God be with you till we meet again, dearest Holy Cross. Go in peace in light of the resurrection. Hold fast to which is good. For the resurrected one walks with you, and so do we. Thanks be to God. Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Alleluia.